I need some ID, love.
Are you serious?
Look how they mess, good my boy.
Hellboy is the 2019 reboot of the Hellboy film franchise. It stars Stranger Things' David Harbour as Hellboy, who, along with a bunch of people who all hate each other, must save the world from an ageless sorceress named Mila Jovovich. I'm not gonna mince words here, folks. This movie kinda sucks. First off, the story of Hellboy 2019 is a confusing, jumbled mess. Hellboy just moves from scene to scene with little rhyme or reason, like the main character in one of those video games where your next objective is always highlighted on the mini-map, even if you have no idea why you're supposed to go there or what's going to happen when you do. Wherever he is currently, on the way to, or happens to wind up at any given time is just exactly where he needs to be for the next part of the plot to activate, oscillating back and forth between poorly edited action scenes with bad CGI and exposition dumps delivered through the most unlikably cynical, badly written dialogue that I've heard in years.
Where's my f***ing violin?
The dialogue honestly felt to me like it was written by a 14-year-old who just discovered all of the different ways they can use the word fuck in a sentence.
Where's my fucking vibe?
And every single character talks like that, except Mila Jovovich, who oddly enough was the only character in the movie I didn't hate. Ian McShane is on autopilot, and the two sidekick characters embody the absolute worst of the cringy dialogue.
Where's my
You can at least tell that David Harbour is doing his best to salvage the lead role. There are a couple of moments where he's effective, and I know from other things he's been in that he is a good actor, but whatever direction he's being given here is really bad. In theory, his character arc should at least work. It's pretty much the same sort of deal as what Ron Perlman's version of Hellboy was going through, i.e. coming to grips with who and what he is, being forced to choose between humanity and monsters even though most of the humans hate him, etc. But it doesn't work here because, like every other character in the movie, Hellboy is just sort of a surly, unpleasant asshole.
Okay.
Ron Perlman's Hellboy was definitely sort of gruff, but there was a cool nonchalance about the character, and he had a lot of heart and depth under the surface that this new version doesn't at all.
Are you serious?
Hellboy 2019 is a hard, hard R. There's tons of gratuitous blood and gore, people getting ripped in half, dismembered, drawn and quartered. I have no problem with R-rated movies, but here it feels like the R rating was just done as a pretext to justify the film's own existence. Like, yeah, remember those old corny Hellboy movies? Well, this is the new extreme Hellboy! Except the old Hellboy movies weren't really corny, they were awesome, and this new one isn't extreme, it's obnoxious, right down to the soundtrack. There's nothing in the movie resembling the epic, rousing, heroic music that the trailer is cut to. Its entire score is nothing but unrelenting, non-stop grunge and guitar wailing, regardless of whether it fits the scene or not. And look, I'm not hating on that style of music, I love that style of music, and there are a couple of really good tracks in there. Kickstart My Heart by Motley Crue is one of my favorite rock songs, but it just gets grating after a while.
Sorry! I interrupt!
But okay, look, I'm not gonna pretend that this movie was a total worthless travesty. Just like the original two films, there's still a lot of excellent practical makeup and creature effects in Hellboy 2019. I actually really liked the scene with the witch. It was genuinely pretty creepy, and I wish more of the movie had had that same tone.
Don't you look lovely?
And also, yeah, if you're down to just see some absolutely insane violence committed by all these different monsters and eldritch abominations, then you'll probably go home happy. But I personally found it overly gratuitous to the point that by the end I was getting pretty bored.
You're
Back to the R rating, though. I think this is probably the most confusing thing to me about the movie's production. See, the first two Hellboy films, while well-reviewed, both suffered from lukewarm box office results and mostly made money on home media sales, fueled by a devoted cult following of not only Hellboy fans, but also fans of writer-director Guillermo del Toro. Del Toro and star Ron Perlman actively tried to get a third film made for years, shopping it around to different studios, but nobody was buying. It didn't seem worth the investment now that home media was mostly dead. But then in 2017, a third film was greenlit, with Ron Perlman even attached to the project for a hot minute before dropping out when Guillermo del Toro was seemingly pushed out.
I quit.
I can't find any sources corroborating this, but that's sure what it looks like happened. I don't know why he would have left the project otherwise, he'd been talking about making it for years prior. Regardless of what happened though, the film was then of course reworked into this thing you see before you, co-written by the original Hellboy comic creator Mike Mignola, who went uncredited in the final version. I don't blame him. The new film is ostensibly closer to the comic series than Del Toro's Hellboy films, but to reiterate, the only reason another Hellboy movie would have been considered viable in the first place is because of fans of those movies. On top of that, the R rating makes it so that you're effectively slashing your potential ticket sales in half on a project that couldn't get off the ground in the first place because it was considered too risky. I don't get it, but anyway, to sum up, go back and watch the other ones instead. They're both much better. I made a whole other video about why that you can check out right here, but if you like this video, you'd be doing me a huge favor if you could hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new, and ring the bell to stay up to date on future videos. Leave a comment down below letting me know any of your thoughts on the Hellboy movies or anything else, and check out some of the other great stuff I've got up here on my channel. Until next time, thanks as always to all of you guys for watching, and take care.